Hi there. In this video I'm going to try and do something that I really didn't need to be doing right about now, and that is troubleshooting my computer which refuses to power on anymore. First thing, obviously, different power cable, cycled it on off, left it to stay for a while just in case something is electrically stuck inside of this PSU, let it discharge and then try to power it on once again, but absolutely nothing. There is absolutely no light on the motherboard, and normally it had some LEDs. It was telling me that it gets 5 volts. That LED is not there anymore, so in theory it's not getting power from the PSU, but if you listen, hopefully you can hear it. I hear a click when I put this in, so the capacitors, at least the main capacitors, are charging. So if there's a problem in the PSU, it's not the fuse, because electricity is getting to the capacitors. So that means this sucks. This sucks really bad and it's extremely annoying. So power everything off, remove the power cable, try to undo these thumb screws and I cannot, remove the panel, remove the PSU, and I don't even know if I have another PSU strong enough to power this thing, at least to know that the PSU is the problem. Hopefully, best case, the PSU is gone and not the motherboard or something else, because that would suck really bad. Okay, so first thing, as you can see, this connector seems to be lifted a little bit. How that happened, I have absolutely no clue, because obviously nobody was inside of this. So there is about 1 in a million chance that it's just not making contact on the standby 5 volt rail. Maybe we are lucky. We will see in a moment. I will unplug it and plug it back in and try to power it on. Okay, so up until now, no signs of life. I have that PSU that has 230 watts. It's a working PSU. No way near enough to power this thing, but I will not power the GPU itself. I will just give power to the motherboard, and sadly I only have a 4 pin instead of 8 pin, so it might not work. Also, this motherboard wants an SATA in. I can give it that, but anyway, the idea is I want to see signs of life. Anything, something trying to start, fans trying to spin, anything, because at the moment it's all fully dead. Ta-da-da! And we have signs of life. That LED is on. So in theory, this thing might even try to power on. Yes. So, force power it off by holding the button. So we have found our culprit. This thing isn't giving the standby 5 volts. Something happened to that particular rail. So I need to open it up, and it's going to be a pain, because look at the wires. But if I remember correctly, it's at least partially modular, so maybe I'm a bit lucky and it won't be that bad, but it will be bad, maybe not that bad. And the PSU is out, and I'm really curious at this point to see what happened inside of this thing, because normally this was quite a good power supply, zero issues whatsoever with it, but something happened. What? I don't know. Hopefully you will simply see a blown capacitor or any other, a blown resistor or something like that, or maybe a fuse on the 5 volt rail. That would be awesome if it has a protection fuse on that, a separate one somehow. I don't know. Anyway, and the wires, Jesus Christ, they are thick. And this was honestly way overkill for this particular computer, but I found it and got it really cheap second hand, so yeah, it's old at this point. What I can do, let's get inside of it and see if we find something that can be fixed, or we need to get another power supply. What do we see here? Right in the middle. That jackass of a capacitor caused this whole beautiful and powerful and well-engineered thing to fail. Even the metal is thick on it. So this is a beautiful and strong power supply. I had to fight for 5 minutes to get this connector out because it was stuck in place with hot glue. This thing is awesome. And that stupid cheap capacitor made this fail. Ain't that cute? Yeah. And the problem is that, as you can see, we are far from having this thing disassembled to be able to change that capacitor. And that kind of sucks. This will not be a tutorial on how to change PSU capacitors. This is just my investigation into my computer not powering on anymore, because it didn't have 5 volt standby, because nothing was lit on the motherboard. And this is the culprit right there smack in the middle. That little jackass. Okay, there's a problem here. This thing is so well built that it's basically not meant to ever be opened up. Even this, which is a power resistor, he is glued to this standoff, and to remove the board I need to undo this standoff, which is glued to everything else around it. They put so much glue into this power supply, and that is a really good thing. The problem is, it's not a good thing because I need to get right in there and get everything out. Not a good idea to touch everything in here, but seeing how well built it has bleed resistors, 99%, still not a good idea to touch it. It could kill you, especially these two little guys, if you touch the contacts on the other side. 450 volts, that would not be fun at all, and would hurt, and presumably will stop your heart, so you don't want your heart to be stopped. The other capacitors, all that I can see, are in good shape. So that one most likely is the one for the 5 volt standby that has gone bad. Now my only idea at this point is measure from this edge and from this edge, and simply really really slowly drill a hole in here, which I don't like, but it's my only option to get to the back of the motherboard and replace that capacitor. Because if I need to take this whole thing out, I don't think I can properly put this PSU back together. It's just too much glue in here, and I don't have this type of glue. This is heat resistant. I have hot snot, which is the one that you melt with a glue gun. That's not heat resistant at all. So this is a really nice PSU, but sadly it's not a repairable, if I can say that, one. So this is gonna be fun. Let the drilling begin. Just remembered something else. Sometimes, if you are lucky enough, you can simply pull on a capacitor and it will detach from its little legs. And we might be left with something that I can solder to from this side. So I will solder 2 small wires and our capacitor will be laying in here somewhere, the replacement. It will not be directly soldered to the board, but I don't need to drill holes, so it's at least worth a try. I'm not losing anything. This is already blown, so yeah. And after pulling on it for about 15 minutes, it's out in pieces. It's a typo, and it's about obviously it got damaged exactly where the value was written. But I managed to read it, 1500 microfarads at 10 volts. 10 volts is right about here in the middle of the screen written, and 1500 at the top. And those are the leads that I was hoping for, and I can solder to them from the top by using this little guy. Let's see how well it fits in there. Yeah, good enough. I can do it. I just need a bit of light, but I can solder to that. So next, let me search for a capacitor of this value. Found two direct replacements, this one right here and this one right here. About this, I don't remember from what I got this part of the board, maybe a TV from these weird connectors or who knows. This one I remember for a fact that it's from a working printer. So, yeah, daughter crying in the background, cool little thing. I must check on her. And this one is at least in good shape. I cannot find my capacimeter to double check it, but 99% of the time from my experience, when they look good, they are actually good. They become quite bloated when they have issues, or they change the color a little bit. Something gives you the warning that something's wrong with it. So this was working, this looks good, taking it out, putting it in. Okay, I managed to solder the wires. They are covered with heat shrink, then with two zip ties onto this cable, so the capacitor isn't flapping around in the breeze. It's quite stiff in there. So yeah, if this was the problem, it should be working now. If this wasn't the problem, it was just a random capacitor that was gone bad, but it was not actually affecting the functioning of this, then I wasted 1 hour for nothing, because about 1 hour it took me to do this whole thing. It was really fiddly and hard to do, but anyway, at this point this should be working perfectly and shouldn't create any future problems whatsoever. So let's attach this thing in the other hole and start putting stuff back together and hope for the best, obviously. This is a beautiful power supply, honestly, but how did he manage to assemble this thing? This wire for the fan is extremely short. It's perfectly fine when it's closed, but when you try to plug it into that while having the cover open, Jesus, it barely reaches. I have no idea how they assembled it, but they did it. Anyway, and I'm reassembling it with that little capacitor right in there, which will make sure it's working, I hope. Okay, all is in, all is connected, but power on and no light on the LED. So this thing is not turning on. That wasn't it. So the capacitor was failing or already failed, but something else got damaged inside that PSU. And being that ultra high compact and quite impossible to open up, I'm just going to buy another one and put it into this computer. Okay, so this is a sad little power supply. I shorted green and black, so in theory it's forcing it to power on, and just from time to time you just get that bulb to shine for split second. If you insist and keep playing with it, maybe you just saw it. Okay, so my daughter saying hello. It's quite clear what's happening. It's some sort of protection is being tripped in this thing. Something shorted internally. That's my bet at the moment. And again, this is not a PSU that you can take apart and put back. It, everything is much too cramped in there. So this is Gansky. We need another one, and I don't know, maybe I will use the fans or who knows what from this one in other projects, and that's about it. Ta-da! Our rescuer has arrived. A Segotep GP750G, 80 gold plus, 650 watts, brand new PSU. You might be wondering, why did I choose this one? Well, this thing is extremely effective. I don't like the term effective. I think efficient is a better term. So it's 92% efficient at 50% load, which the computer presumably most of the time will be at that load. So this is a really nice power supply in my opinion. And it had all the connectors that I needed, because this is not your standard case. As you can see, wires need to be quite long to reach at the other end and then back up to the motherboard. It's a bit weird, but anyway, this thing is awesome. Plenty of power for what we need. The old one, 1000 watts, was extremely overkill. It was in this system just because I got it really cheap second hand from somebody, and I put it there. It was cheap once again, and it didn't hurt a lot. It was not that efficient, so in terms of power usage it wasn't that great, but anyway, so that was really overkill. This presumably is still a bit overkill, but much better suited for the system. So let's open it up and put it in there and hope for the best, because if it's still something not working, then we have a big problem. I must say that I like this packaging instead of the white one that comes apart and fills your whole house with little specks. This one stays together. And we have a new power cable, which is okay. Didn't need one, but why not? Obviously a bunch of cables right here. This is not a modular supply, but the cables are exactly the ones that we need, so that is perfect. Some zip ties, some screws, the four ones that you normally use for the PSU, but we have the old ones, so that doesn't matter. And yes, obviously the PSU itself in this bubble wrap, and I will get it out and take a look at it. Let's quickly take a look at the connectors. So we have 2x8 PCI on white one cable for the GPU, on another cable again 2x8. I think we will be using only one of these, so three of them will be free. That's a bit overkill again. 24 pin for the motherboard, clearly. 8 pin for the CPU, I think it's EPS also called. 4 plus 4 also for the CPU, which is basically identical to the one with... Or actually, is this a 4 plus 4? Yeah, both of them are 4 plus 4, which is awesome, because you can use them on various types of motherboards. Another thing, let's watch here. So it's the old Molex, three of them plus one floppy. Some card readers still use this, as I've seen, so it's good to have it. We are not using it in our case, but it's good to have it around. On another cable, Molex, another Molex, and two ESATA. And on the last cable, ESATA, and another ESATA, and my daughter's playing next to me. And these things are long. I will put a link in the description that gives you how long they are, but they are extremely long. So I checked that before getting the PSU. I needed them to be long, and they are. 12 centimeter fan. I like the fact that this thing is all black, and it matches the rest of this thing, which is also all black, at least apart from the Noctua and the memory, Noctua fans and the memory. And yeah, that's about it. Let's get this thing in there. If you want to see the specs, it gives 54 amps on the 12 volt rail. That's good. That's good for this system. Perfect. So let's get it in there and hope that everything powers on and works normally. All cables in position. Also for the motherboard and GPU. And in here, everything also in position, zip tied in place. Yes, this end right here is a bit of a bird's nest, but I have a few adapters. One adapter right here, one adapter right there. So this card, that's an USB, needs power from a Molex. Then from the same Molex, I'm giving power to a fan on the top of the case. It's, yeah, nothing that I can do. It is what it is. And it was the same with the other PSU, so nothing changed. Let's put the covers and try to power it on and just cross our fingers that it works normally now. And yes, it needs a bit of a cleaning. If I see that everything works normally, I will blow some compressed air onto it to get rid of the dust. Okay, it all goes down to this. PSU is on. We see a LED down in there.
Diana? Diana? Hai să apeși mami pe ăsta.
And I ask my daughter to come and press the magic power button. Fans are on. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't press it again. We don't want it off. Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Image. We need image. Why don't we have image? Yes, we have image. Yep, we have image. Haha, okay, this thing is working. And we fixed it. So the PSU was gone for who knows what reason. GeForce, GTX, somewhere in there. Cannot focus on it. Anyway, solved. Whew. So, thank you for watching. This was a video that I wasn't planning to make, but yeah, components fail from time to time. Nothing that we can do about it, apart from and the BIOS has default settings. I think if I shut it off and presumably turn it on again, it forgets about those and gets back to the overclocking settings. If not, I will enter the BIOS and set it myself to overclocking. Anyway, yeah, computer components do fail from time to time. Nothing that you can do apart from figure out which one of them failed, change it, and hope that everything works. Come on. Show me the logo without stupid message of... yeah, I need to enter the BIOS and make the settings again for the overclock. Anyway, that's not an issue. So, see you in the next video. Hopefully a more cheerful one. Bye.